My name is Nick Trankner.
Hi, Nick.
Hi. There is a little reverb on this to add to the drama. This is a poetry reading. It's an open mic. Eventually, we wanted to have a couple featured readers, so you're all featured readers tonight. We have a sign-up sheet. As you walk through the brick archway, it's to your left. We have 13 readers right now. So if you get on, you're going to get right when the getting's good, because you'll get at 14 and you'll break the curse. I'd like to thank Steve Goldberg and Andy and Linda.
Yay!
Nice, Nick. Yes. Steve and I were talking about poetry, and I was talking to Andy about a poetry reading, and he was saying how these happened at the early onset of the Literary Cafe here when he took over. So I said, why not? And I said, let's do it. Let's do it in November. And then we pick November 3rd. And that's my first poem.
Oh.
All right. I put myself down as first on the list because nobody else would.
I would,
huh? The first poem I'm going to read is called Again. This was written probably 3 weeks ago. And it starts out with a quote from T.S. Eliot. There's no more use trying... I'm not trying to reverb off.
I'm trying to reverb off.
There's no more use trying to be traditional than it is trying to be original. Back then, they were concerned about trying to be traditional, I guess. The name of the poem is Again. Again, the thing... A sprig of leaves imparts lives deeply in the humility of muttered voices that avoid pretentiousness, sterility, ensues as wretched product as supple smoke of cigarettes from careful guided policies of artful business etiquettes. Smudged gray eyes on hard-grown boys, silk robes of an authority are lightly dropped around their necks and proudly worn invisibly. Somehow we are doomed to walk a path laid not so absently by accidental place settings of the dead's discovery. And dealing with the scratch of ink, we fast adopt his powdered feet in Missouri pilgrim leather laced virgins on sawdust neon streets. And as we mutter carefully, some difficult, some easily, we intersect again this trail in crevices, we breathe fresh air and ask ourselves yet once again, what was that you said? Dig it.
I'm with you, man.
That's right.
What a cat.
To keep up with the sing-song rhythmic metered shit, I'm going to read some sonnets.
People still write those.
No, they don't.
No, they don't.
No, they don't.
No, they don't.
Yeah, they do. So you want to hear a sonnet about goth kids in the chamber in Lakewood?
Oh, yeah.
Hell yeah.
Are they naked?
No.
Yeah, well.
It's called Mope Sonnet. Be natural in this forest of black torsos, the hands joined together behind, playfully swinging the feet forth and back. Sometimes maypole, sometimes hanged man, you find stone deep beating, original artist mind, obsessed starlight synthesis corruption of delicate children, they too unwind under black canopy stillborn function. Expressed as cigarette poison suction, electronic clip purring subwoofer, slide dancing rabbits, squirrels in motion, elegant bears dressed as Lucifer, Space boot astro girl, neck stud contortions, the dead fat hand of desire, loved lost proportions. This is my favorite of the sonnets. There's two of them that I wrote. I wrote this in Kent in 2002. Walking from my house down to Susan's, I think, to get a cup of coffee and saw a crushed can on the
coffee,
side.
We got coffee here.
We do got coffee and we got espresso. The beatnik by the coffee will help you out with that.
Oh, is it free?
No.
Yeah. Free. You give me some green, man.
It's free, but the coffee is free.
It's free.
The revolution costs money.
Gas for that's right.
Oh, my God.
Crush Can's sonnet. The bees awake. In dream they buzz in hives of rope by rivers down in thorny weeds. In dreams I use my face. Observe the lives of poison insect madness at top speeds. Aluminum reflection intercedes from on the pavement flattened to a plane. A patch, a silver blotch of blue proceeds nearby the newborn grass in clumps. The pane of light, long rolled by tires, pelted by rain, melts into shrub bud vicious springtime fray. It's trash against the green mist air, the strain of poetry against the world's bouquet of combinations formed by gods and man together, amplified by light and can. And then one more sonnet, and then I'll read a fun poem. Those are all fun poems. I'll read a poem that has the word fuck in it.
Yeah.
I think. And if it doesn't, I'll add the word fuck to it.
Nice.
This is called Streetlight Sonnet. It was also written in Kent. The dappled shine of streaking light is splayed, pebbled, forking colors. A crossing post pulls orange, red, and blue from signs displayed. Dry, lights fly by, spreading, blurring into ghost. But here the water fills this street scene most with lights. It brings on blade-like sharpened beam, brief streaks across the intersection, coast for chasing then by further lights that gleam behind red taillight streaks. Rapid, they seem to stretch into distances, vanishings, horizon lines defined by stars, a dream of neon, plastic, streetlight flourishings, reflected out across the rainy night, oh artifice of artificial light. All right, now the crazy shit that I haven't read in a while. No. The pink perfect circle is not time. The pink perfect circle blue smiles bright polyester ether green pant knee orange light finger presence. The street lamp turns on and her face is almost pressed against the window. There is no music playing except the fragile percussion against the glass gloved fingers spreading fine hairs into lightened pads. She wants one. Stiff ankles, careful, drifting eyeballs in gray water, twist in as much before you, find absolute starlight in an afternoon where no sun gives you time, no sun points at you, nothing at anything. Peace, like a dead peace. Peace of frostbite. Peace of dry air. Peace of slow murmurs. There are clear markings before the plow. An evil heart can make you howl. There is no certain picture of the sun. I guess that's that poem. Oh, fuck. Thank you. And one more. And then next we have Steve Smith.
Woo!
Woo!
Together. I'll end this on a light note. Not really.